the BJP's Mamata Kale on these developments that have taken place today. Mamata, first to you, just the fact that, you know, that a big film star like Deepika Padukone today showed up in solidarity with JNU. Very rare for Bollywood big stars to do that. How do you see it?
Nidhi, as far as Deepika is concerned, she is a citizen of India and she has all the right to go anywhere and, you know, talk about any issue. Our constitution gives the right of freedom of speech to everyone. So it's okay. I mean, I don't see a big problem in it, number one. Number two, I have been a student leader myself, Nidhi. I am an ABVP product, but I simply reject such a politics, you know, which happened yesterday or on Saturday in JNU, you know, where actually we were talking about silencing the dissent. This, you know, silencing dissent is, it is about when the students of JNU wanted to study and you don't let them do. That is what silencing dissent is all about. When they wanted to actually register themselves and they were not allowed, that is, you know, actually suppressing dissent is. Or dissent is when actually they wanted to do what they are supposed to do in a university.
Masked,
then you
and masked attackers going and beating up students and teachers and assaulting them. There's a big difference between what you're talking about and, you know, masked goons going into the campus, assaulting students under the watch of the police and being escorted out also under the watch of the police.
So Nidhi, this actually started on Saturday afternoon at 1 p.m. when the goons or these masked so-called students, you know, went to the server room, vandalized the server room, shut the server room, cut the Wi-Fi wires and didn't let the registration process happen. ABBP wanted the registration process to go through. And when they couldn't do it, they went to Perrier Hostel, beat them up. I am not justifying it, but I am just trying to... I am not doing that, Nidhi. Please let me complete. Please allow me my time. I am not justifying it, but I am showing you the other side of the picture also. When these students went to the Perrier hostel and threw stones at ABVP students, beat them up there, and when the teachers, the staff of JNU said, why are you shutting the server room, they actually beat them also. You know, when security came in rescue of the staff, they started thrashing them as well. This is what you call student leadership? What is it?
Can
this
I ask you though, Mamata, that you don't find it rather strange that two days after this assault happened on the campus that not a single person has been arrested for the violence that was perpetrated on JNU? That not a single arrest has been made? You don't think that's a little strange and instead an FIR has been lodged against those students who were injured?
No, let me answer this also. As far as injuries are concerned, 25 of ABVP karyakartas got injured quite badly. Ujwal got 16 stitches on his skull. Mr. Jangid got 2 fractures. So it is both ways. You know, it's not one side. As far as Miss Ghosh is concerned, she is being seen very clearly letting the goons in. I wonder as to, as a student leader, as the president of JNU, how can you do such a thing, Nidhi? How can you let these goons inside? What was the intention? Why did you do it at the first place?
That is a charge that she has denied. Are you saying she wasn't beaten up with iron rods?
Politics.
Are you saying she wasn't beaten up with iron rods and you're not answering my question? Do you think the police have done a good job? They've not arrested a single person for that attack on JNU.
No, I did.
Not a single arrest. Zero.
No, I did not say anything of that sort, number one. But yes, what Aishi did is absolutely wrong, uncalled for. She's a student leader. She happens to be the president of JNU. She is not supposed to bring in these goons and make her own people.
What about the goons
get into this vandalism?
Firstly, she denies that we've been showing that clip. But what about the goons who entered with the police's connivance and exited also with the police's connivance? And the ABVP links to those that we exposed yesterday on NDTV and the Indian Express exposed today. The WhatsApp groups that were planning this attack on JNU, which shows links to the ABVP. What about that?
Okay, fine. In that case, if you can zoom in here, even I have these, these video chat, WhatsApp chats, where these core group of left says that abhi Sangiyo ki pitai karni hai. Comrade, come with rod and sticks.
I'm not asking you what about.
Hai na?
I'm asking you about
them. So even I have these things. No, I am showing you the other side of the
ABVP.
Other side of the
picture also,
Nidhi. There is evidence of
camera. I cannot only carry your narrative. ABVP members on camera with lathis.
Oh, these are the...
Are you denying that they were there?
So I am also showing you the evidence.
I'm asking you about this first before you show me the evidence.
No, I am showing you rest other.
So you're not answering the question about the ABVP.
No, why? I want to show. I want you to see these evidence.
I will
also
see that as well. But can you first answer on ABVP?
You know,
could you first answer
you
on the ABVP links?
One side and just completely
no, no, no.
ignore the
I'm
other
happy
side.
To. I'm happy to see what you're saying. But Mamta, could you answer the question first?
I am answering. I am answering. I am answering your question. I am answering your question. You please allow me some time, Nidhi. Thank you. You know, as far as any student, be it ABVP or any other student is concerned who's actually carrying a lathi, what would the students do if they are being beaten up so brutally, blue and black, their skulls are fractured? What do they do?
Their skulls
they take
are fractured?
For
you have evidence of this?
You
that
want
their
them
skulls
to be
were
killed
fractured?
Completely? Is that
we
what
didn't
we
see
want?
Any ABVP
and as far as police
skulls fractured?
As far as
Mamta,
police is concerned,
Nidhi,
when police was called,
sorry,
they went inside.
Do you have a name for the whose skull was fractured? Allegedly?
Sorry?
Do you have a name of whose skull was fractured?
Nidhi, on reality check, you had one ABVP representative yesterday on your channel.
Was his skull
Please
fractured?
Check those videos. His skull was, he had five stitches.
A very serious injury.
There is one guy who got 16 stitches.
Okay.
Mr. Jangir, Manish Jangir, who was the president candidate, got two fractures. I am giving you the name.
Okay.
Nidhi, I am giving you
the
name.
Well,
but
by the way, we reported the ABVP injuries as well yesterday.
Mamta,
we reported the ABVP injuries
as
well.
As far as police is concerned, hear me now, you spoke about police also. As far as police is concerned, police had gone there, they did their duty. But you know what happens is when the police went into Jamia, these were the same people who brought the whole city down by screaming their lungs out. How dare the police enter wherein the VC of Vice Chancellor
right.
of Jamia
so
came
in Jamia
said
the
on
police
every
went and entered
that we have only 3,
they entered
students.
Anyway
but there
and
were 30,000 people started
they knew
inside.
That for several hours
27,000 people
men had gone in
and when
right under their nose
men
with weapons
to
so you are justifying
them,
the,
all of
you are
you
justifying what
say,
the police has done
do this?
You are justifying what the police has
oh,
done
no.
under
am,
their
I
nose
you the
they have watched masked
Nidhi.
Men go
I
inside with weapons and escorted
I am
them out
showing you the clear picture even the
no,
police
that's not the clear picture
up.
What
that's
your
want,
version
you
of
want
it?
The police to be beat up you want these so called goons who were not the students by
they
the way
so called
you want those students to
burn
the buses.
Are you saying that the students of JNU beat themselves
want,
up?
Is that what you want our nation to reduce to?
Are you saying the students beat themselves up?
Of course, this is what the left did.
They
why
beat themselves
they,
up.
Why did Aishi let the goons in?
So they
why
beat themselves
they,
up.
Why did they
is
shut
that
the
what
server
you're saying?
Room? Why did they cut Wi-Fi wires? Why did they beat... The staff of JNU, why did they beat security people? Why did they do that? Why
All right,
did they
so, so your version is that the police has done no wrong.
On
so-called goons and the students of JNU who were assaulted on Sunday night and the teachers
showing.
Who were assaulted on Sunday night all beat themselves up. I have heard everything. 20 years of doing television and I swear this is the first time I've heard something
I
like
that.
Mamta Kale, thank you very much
mouth,
for
Nidhi.
Joining
please
us on NDTV
that. I know
tonight.
You're an expert in doing that, but kindly do not do that, Nidhi. Kindly do
That's
not do that.
That's what you're saying, Mamta. I want to play out for you though. I want to, please watch this. The questions that the JNU's own professors have raised about the sequence of events that night and how the police stood by and almost aided those goons who went in on campus and assaulted students and teachers. Take a look at this.
The JNU faculty is describing it as the most blatant and disgraceful behavior by the police in actually helping the violence in JNU. The faculty is concerned that the police surreptitiously opened the gates, allowed only masked goons to enter, then shut the gates so nobody else could enter. The gates were kept shut while the violence took place. Then, after 2 hours, the police surreptitiously opened the gates only to allow the goons to leave without being checked. The first questions being asked by the JNU faculty, why did the police open the gates, stand by watching, and then allow more than 60 masked goons to enter the JNU campus? Why didn't they demand to check ID cards and whether these masked goons were students? Finally, why didn't the police ask the goons to take off their masks? The next questions being asked by JNU faculty, why did the police shut the gates immediately after the masked goons entered? Why did they stop any others from entering to check on what the goons were doing inside the campus? Why did the police stop the media from entering? It was during this time that the violence took place when the gates were shut. Finally, the big question the JNU faculty is asking is this. After the violence was over, why did the police quietly open the gates and allow the goons to leave again without checking? JNU is now waiting for the footage from the security cameras at the gates to be released. Why hasn't the footage been released already? For its own credibility, the police needs to answer these key and disturbing questions.
That's it on Left, Right and Center tonight. Sanket is up next with Trending.